What the fuck are they fucking puff back at it again? How you doing today? Today we, I am behind quite badly. I forgot to do last week's. I thought I uploaded it. I thought I even recorded it, and I went back in my video reels and I realized I didn't do it. So I'm a little behind, but I also have, I have week six and week seven today. Two separate videos, obviously. Not going to do them all both at the same time. Want to get a chance to see both of them. We only have one tribute of note for this week itself like that. This is the week that came from February 4th to February 10th. This is the week 6 of 2022. And the only one from that one is a great one. According to my mother, not type of music I listen to. I'm not that type of person on thing, but 2-8 Burt Bacharach passed away, so we're gonna give a little 15-second tribute to him with "What the World Needs Now Is Love." Good message. Terrible segue coming up after. Gave our little tribute, little nice little thing, sent him off to the great world of everything else and who knows and beyond, we don't know. Terrible segue that I was talking about. He would go right into the top 10 after we say what the world needs now is love and give a great freaking tribute to the great Burt Bacharach. We come up with again another shout out to my friend's band, Wesley Robinson, here you go again, boy. Great freaking song, just unfortunately a lot of great songs this week. Sorry, dude, couldn't get you higher. I have to rate all genres and a few other ones in other genres that are a little bit better. But you still made the list. Number 10, Liminal, Born to Hate. Because copyright trolls suck and I hate them, and we gotta keep going and keep on playing them. We gotta keep going because we can't play them all, but it's a sick ass song. You gotta freaking listen to it, get a chance to it, and stuff like that. But on number 9, we have Plain White Tees with Spaghetti Tattoo. Yeah, I couldn't believe the Hey There Delilah came back again. Either.
Traffic be there soon. Throw some money in the meter. 15 minutes late to meet her. Running past the movie theater. Nervous in the elevator. Will I like her? Will I hate her? Will she leave me for the waiter? But there you are, there you are.
And copyright trolls suck and I hate them. Gotta keep going, keep on playing them. We have, I don't know if this is just the name of the artist or the name of the band. Don't know much about them yet. I don't know why I didn't look into them. But sometimes I don't look into them until afterwards, and you never know. They may make a top list for the whole entire year, and then I go into full detail about them. But we have Amber Run with Honey Light.
Into it, you just exist, and you die. I'm under no illusion that things get better, but I'll try.
And copyright Retro Sucker. Hey, I'm guys. Keep moving, Kylie. Keep playing them. Next up, we have The Strange Juice by Dead Lakes. Copyright Trolls Suck. I hate them. Gotta keep going. Gotta keep playing them. Going back on the list and just telling off what it is. Number 10, we got Liminal with Born to Hate. That band is like, imagine the musical style of Born of Osiris meets Avenged Sevenfold with a screamer that's similar to Attila mixed with Busta Rhymes and put some real like technical hip hop jazz and reggae freaking drum beats to it. Like, the guy who plays drums does not play drums like a metalcore drummer. It doesn't make any sense to me, but great reviews always on them. Plain White Tees, that song is worth, it's called Spaghetti Tattoo. It's definitely worth the listen at number 9. Number 8, Amber Run with Honey Light. Listen to the whole entire song. It's a great-ass song and stuff like that. They remind me a lot of a mixture of Muse and Coldplay with a little bit of like, what do I want to say? Almost like Hurt, almost in a way. The band, not the rapper. Different people. And then Dead Lakes kind of sounds like a cross between Jimmy Eat World and like a thrashier Green Day, almost in a way. It's weird. They're all weird bands, weird, unusual things. We're going up into number 6 right now with Gracie Adams' Amelie. This one, she sounds like a raspier but more soulful and ethereal version of Fiona Apple with a little bit of a Lana Del Rey influence. And it's weird because the next person after this has almost got the same type of thing, so I was hard putting them on the list because they were like right next to each other. Same week? Who knows? But this one's Gracie Adams with Amelie. Hint to it and stuff because the instrumentation in the beginning gave it a little bit of things, but you gotta hear her vocals on her chorus, so let me try to see if I can get another 30 seconds out. Copyright Trolls Suck.
We sat on the sofa. She asked me a million questions. I answered and by 11 memorized her face. Where did you go?
Gorgeous voice. But, and then, again, same description for the other one from this one and stuff. This one is Mia Ray with Happy, but she's got a little more of like a, like the Lana Del Rey, but the soulfulness of like, just listen. Called Happy.
I'm gonna make a change, gonna start anew. Have to take a different view. I'm happy tonight.
It's like Avril Lavigne and Tracy Chapman got together. I don't know. It's weird.
And in this world of war and self-decay, I wish I could say I'm okay. I'm happy. happy tonight.
Sir, we gotta stop it because copyright trolls suck and I hate them. Gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them. All right. For weirdest combinations of artists of the year award so far, we're going to put Logic and Norah Jones together. What? What? I've seen Norah Jones. I love Logic. Neither of them should be mentioned in the same category, and too bad a lot of her vocals don't come until the end, but I'm not going through this entire song, so I'm only going to give you the first 30-second snippet, and we'll just move on, as we normally do. Paradise 2.
Cruising through the borderlands, catch a vibe. Fatherhood, my hustle nowadays. I'm making music on the side. I confide in the page. Weed smoke, fill the air like sage. 32 my age. I spot a couple grays, feel my blood pressure raise. No longer are the days of my childhood. My priority nowadays is.
And we gotta stop it there because copyright trolls suck and I hate them. Gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them. Next on the list at number 3, we have Mr. Soy Un Perdedor. I'm a loser, baby, freaking Beck. And for the few people I've played it for, they really think that Beck is playing music like Bob Dylan, but singing like soulful Bob Dylan? Bob Dylan, if he actually had a voice? I mean, this one's weird. It's called Thinking About You, number 3. It literally sounds like Bob Dylan met, like, I'm sorry to admit, but David Crosby, RIP, from earlier this year. Up next at number 2, we got Lizzo and SZA doing Special. Stop it, stop it, stop it. I hate the copyright trolls.
Who I'm supposed to be, I'm just acting up. A crash is fucking never saying sorry. Found out in the end that I can only do it for me. You call it sensitive and I call it superpower. You just lack empathy because you think it gives you power.
The vocal arrangement is just gorgeous on that song. But as we say, we don't play too much of them and stuff like that. I had to snip that one off a little bit because that is just a gorgeous song. But yeah. It's empowering. It's a good song. Let's keep songs like that in the thing. Even though the last song in number 1 is called Lost, it's still empowering to hear that there was some tracks that we didn't get a chance to hear that Linkin Park thought that weren't ready for the audience at that time. And honestly, this is a good time for this song. And I heard it cracked the top 40. So, go figure. I heard it went to number 32. Go figure. Something I had that's on the top 40 is actually my number 1 song, Linkin Park Lost. 45 seconds going on in. What the fuckity fucking puff? Copyright trolls suck and I hate them. Gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them.
Down inside of me.
right there, because I'm trapped in yesterday. R.I.P. Chester. We still miss you. What the fuckity fucking puff? Copyright trolls suck. Copyright trolls suck and I hate them. Gotta keep going, gotta keep playing them. Peace be with you. There.